I today we had a meetup on our Discuss Agile network. It was a coffee meetup where we went into the discussion without having any predefined agenda. So what I did is that I collected the opinion, the topics which people wanted to discuss. We created a product backlog or a discussion backlog based on the audience view, based on the participants view. Then we did a prioritization of those topics by using dot voting. And finally, we allocated a time box for the discussion. So there was a predefined time box of 1 hour where we picked up the high priority topics and moved them through in process to done. We could discuss three topics in this particular meetup. The first one was related to why Agile. So this crowd was mix of Agile practitioner and traditional project managers or traditional programmers. So they were coming up with a lot of waterfall kind of thinking where they see a lot of value in waterfall kind of practices, and there were set of people who were coming from Agile. So we had a great discussion related to why do we need Agile. People were proving that this can be done in Agile, and the same thing somebody was contradicting that this can also be done in waterfall. Finally, we had a great conclusion, great summary, where all of the participant accepted that it's a matter of context. We need to see what kind of product we are delivering. Is it working in a very uncertain environment, or is it following a predictive life cycle? So if it is adaptive, if things are changing, we need to keep pace with the market. The Agile makes sense. And then we also looked at how and what dimension of any problem, and if you have an uncertainty in how or uncertainty in what, Agile makes great sense. So that was the first topic which we had a discussion on. The second topic was a bit technical, so one of the participants raised, and it got prioritized also, the difference between definition of ready, definition of done, and acceptance criteria. So it was more like an Agile terminology related question. I surprised to see that even many of the participants have been following Agile for a while, but they still struggle to differentiate between definition of done, definition of ready, and acceptance criteria. Many people were mixing acceptance criteria and definition of done. Some of them were not even seeing value in definition of done. Say that why don't the acceptance criteria takes care of everything? Why do we need a separate definition of done? Definition of ready, I found that it was quite a new term for many of the attendees. So we had a great discussion about it. We summarized it, why it is needed. It is needed to communicate that these items are ready for the team to be picked on. And definition of ready is something which tells that, okay, this item is ready to be picked in your upcoming sprint. We also had a great discussion where we looked into the utility of definition of done and acceptance criteria. Acceptance criteria more talks about business and product owner language, where definition of done is something, a checklist, something like a technical list, which we should be doing before we say something is completed. It is more to deal with developing a common language in all of the Scrum team members or Agile team members. Then we had a discussion, the third topic, about the communication, about the reporting, how do we report progress in Agile. So people came up with their experience with the burn down chart, with the velocity, with various type of Agile terminology, Agile reports which they have been using various packages. Some people raised a query about that, why don't we monitor or measure the schedule variance, cost variance, delay against a milestone in Agile. Then again, we went back to the context and we again spoke about that, why do we need Agile? Agile is less to do with conformance. It is more to do with solving the high value problem, looking at the business values. So again, we looked into the context, and then we came up with that why Agile measurement has to be different from a defined process. Because if you are too much focusing on variance, if you are too much focusing on compliance, it means you have a very defined process. If you already have a defined process, then the Agile or Scrum may not make that much sense for that particular context. So that was the interesting talk. Finally, somebody raised that, what is the difference between Agile and Scrum? And I was expecting that people would be giving answers like this, but this also took a good time. Yeah, we figured it out, and people were surprised to know that Scrum slightly like was ahead of the Agile Manifesto. So there was good number of talks was happening on Scrum before even Agile Manifesto got written. So I spoke about the history of Agile Manifesto. I spoke about how this the lightweight methodologies came together and agreed on values and principle. And Agile is just a collect is values and principle. It doesn't recommend how to do things. It doesn't recommend that you need to have a role called product owner. Whereas Scrum comes up with many practices, gives you a framework. Which helps you to implement agile values and principle. All in all, it was a great meetup, and I would recommend you to have a look at what our audience are sharing after finishing this particular meetup.